Why, hello everyone, I'm JDC Violin, and in this special Halloween tutorial, I'm going to be working in Unity to add some sounds to a zombie. I picked up a few assets from the Unity store and they're just so spooky and so great, so I'm gonna link them in the description so you can check them out if you wanna use them. Also, the awesome script that I'm going to be using in this episode is from the great Bjorn Jacobsen from the YouTube channel Cujo Sound. So I'm gonna link that in the description as well. You should go check out his tutorials. He has some great implementation stuff, as well as some awesome analyses on game audio and sound design. So without further ado, let's step right into Unity and let's get started. Here we are in Unity, and I have a scene open here already. It's a free scene that I downloaded from the Unity Assets Store. You can check it out in the description below. I also downloaded some spooky zombie prefabs, and I'm gonna take one of those and drop it right around here. And I am going to rotate it so that it faces this way. As you can see, I am in a graveyard, and the player is right in the middle of the tombstones. Very creepy, very unsettling. And let's just look for our zombie right here and let's rename him Frank. That's a good name. Let's check out how Frank moves in the scene. As you can see, Frank walks in place and pretends to attack, but doesn't really move. So I'm gonna fix that by adding a really simple script that I made. Don't judge my script, I'm not a professional programmer. And it does look a little wonky. He keeps moving even when he's attacking. But again, I'm not a programmer, so this is the best I could do. And wow, he looks pretty creepy. Let's make him even creepier and let's add some sounds to him. I have some footstep sounds and some growl sounds. So we are gonna make him growl and when he walks, make some noise. So let's begin by going down here to the zombie animations. Let's open this one that says walk in place. As you can see, there's a little window here where we can see the animation playing. We are gonna look for the place where the foot touches the floor. Right around here. Go to events. We're gonna make a new event and we're gonna call this event left foot. And then we are gonna scroll a little more, add another event, and we'll call it right foot. We're gonna hit apply, don't forget. So what we want now is to trigger our events in the animation with some audio for the footsteps. So they play every time he makes a footstep. So let's create a new C# script and we are going to call it animation audio trigger. This script is gonna control all of the sound that is attached to the animation of the zombie. So we're gonna delete the void update function. And let's begin by making a require component type of audio source. And what this does is whenever you put the script onto an object, it automatically makes a new audio source for the object. It's just good practice to include this whenever your script requires something like this. Now we are gonna create our audio source variable that we are gonna reference later. So we're gonna make a private audio source, and we're gonna call it sound source. So now we're gonna make a public audio clip array, and we are gonna call it footstep sounds. In this array is where we are gonna place all of our footstep sounds. Let's exit the script for a moment, and we are gonna go up to Frank, and we are gonna attach this script, the animation audio trigger, to Frank right here. As you can see, it created an audio source. Let's tick off play and awake. We don't need that. So as you can see, the array has nothing in it. But if we go here, let's lock the inspector and go to audio. We can see we have a few footstep sounds. We have four. We're gonna drag them into the array. And now the array has four sounds. Go back to the script and in void start, we want to get the component and associate it with our audio source. Sound source equals get component audio source. So what this line right here does is it looks for any audio sources in the object and associates it with the sound source variable, which we already established is an audio source variable. Let's reference our animation events here. We're gonna make a public void, and we are gonna call it the same name as the animation event. This is very important. Let's call it left foot, just like it was in the animation. And now that we have this public void referencing our animation event, we are gonna randomize our footsteps inside of this void. So whenever the left foot event takes place, the audio source is gonna play our random footstep in the list that we set. So first, what we're gonna do is create an integer. Let's call it n, and we're gonna make it equal to random.range. And the range of the randomization is going to be from 1 to the footstep sound's length. And I will explain why we make it 1 and not 0 in a second. So the next thing we have to do is associate the chosen random sound with the audio source clip. So what we're going to do here is we're going to say sound source.clip is going to be equal to footstep sounds array number n, which is the variable that we specified above. After we associate the sound with the clip, we are going to play it. Sound source.play one shot. And with the play one shot function, we need to specify what the clip is. So we're going to say sound source.clip. And there we go. So this is going to choose a random sound in our array. It's going to associate it with the sound source.clip, and then it's going to play it. Now we need to make sure that it doesn't repeat a sound twice in a row. Let's go down here and let's say that footstep sounds n are now going to be equal to 0. And that is why we did not include 0 in the range above, because we want to leave 0 clear to be able to shuffle our sounds. Footstep sounds 0 are going to be equal to sound source.clip. And we are done with this left foot. So now we're going to copy paste this entire thing down below, and we're going to change the void's name to right foot. And it's going to be exactly the same thing, except it's going to trigger whenever the event right foot is triggered in the animation. So let's save our script and let's see how it works. So as you can hear, the zombie is making footstep sounds whenever he walks. So these sounds are 2D. And we want the sounds to come from the 3D world. So let's go down here to the audio source. Check out our spatial blend curve. We're going to make it so whenever we get close to the zombie, the listener will be able to hear the sound in 2D. But the farther away we get, the sound just turns into 3D sound. Let's check out how this distance works. All right. So the sound is in 3D. And when we get closer, we hear it very close. All right, so this zombie needs to be meaner for sure. I have some growl sounds here, and I'm gonna make them play whenever he does the attack animation. So let's look for that animation. Here it is. Let's unlock the inspector, and we can see the attack animation. So let's make this play right at the beginning of this animation, right around here. We're gonna add an event. This event is gonna be called growl sound. And let's hit apply. Let's go back into our script. And we are going to make the same thing that we did for the footsteps. But first, we need to add another array for our attack sounds. And we're going to call it growl sounds. Let's go into Unity for a second. Let's take a look at our zombie. And we can see that now we have an array down here. Let's lock the inspector, go up to audio here. Let's take all of these growls and let's drag them in. Now we have 8 growl sounds. Go back into our script. We're making a public void, and we need to call it the same thing we called the animation event. So growl sound. We're gonna select an integer n equals random.range from 1 to growl sounds.length. Make sure that our sound source.clip is equal to our growl sounds. And then our sound source is going to play one shot of sound source.clip. Now let's just make sure that our growl sounds are now equal to 0. And let's make sure that they are now associated with the sound source Clip. So we should be good to go. Let's check out Frank's new growls. All right, creepy stuff. So now our zombie has become much more alive by just using a few simple sounds and a few simple scripts. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope that everyone has a very spooky Halloween, and I will see you in the next one.